Good morning, everyone. Let's turn to the inside cover of our hymnal and let's recite together the synodal prayer to the Holy Spirit. We stand before you, Holy Spirit.
Good morning. Welcome to Nativity of Our Lord Parish. Let us begin our celebration by singing hymn number 515, We Walk by Faith. Please rise.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. And welcome, everyone. It's great to see everybody on this 11th Sunday of Ordinary Time. It's also, of course, Father's Day weekend. What a beautiful morning the Lord has provided us with, and he continues to shower his gifts down upon us in many different ways. It's up to us to see the way in which things grow in our lives and how we notice how they're growing, even in the smallest details. But as we prepare, and oh yeah, I had a good vacation. It was good. I stayed around the area. I did go out fishing a little bit and did catch some fish and stuff, so it was good. It was nice. It was beautiful being, it's always good being out in nature and enjoying God's gifts. But as we prepare to enter more deeply into these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father and intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
And let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I, too, will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel, I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous. Although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields a sickle at once, for the harvest has come. He said, 'To whom shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, that when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade.' With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. With all parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private." The Gospel of the Lord. Beautiful readings that we have today. God is always trying to get us to understand the way in which he works, doesn't he? One of the things, of course, with our parable is we can see that God likes to start out small. In small ways. We see it with his own, even with his own coming, how he came to a small town called Bethlehem and was born in that town, born to a virgin mother. Nobody was really around to even see it. And yet, things started to grow. even with the apostles, starting out with 12 of them, the calling of them, starting out with two of them. And God continues to grow, to seek the understanding of the way in which God works in our lives. It's a beautiful readings that we have for this day, especially as we have the reading from that from Ezekiel. If we don't know about who Ezekiel is, he's the first prophet to go and be a prophet outside of Israel, who God called to be a prophet. What had happened is, of course, the Babylonian exile is what happened. It's the worst time in Israel's history. The kings, of course, weren't listening to what Ezekiel was saying and the other prophets and what God was speaking to them. They were trusting in their own hands, their own alliances, their political leaders. And Babylon comes and smashes them. Hauls off the first group of people in 597. All the leaders, all the important people get hauled off to Babylon. Ezekiel is one of the priests, the temple priests, that is hauled off along with them. We can only imagine how horrible it must have been for them. And what Ezekiel must have been going through. But then all of a sudden he starts saying, there's going to be this sprout from the cedar. God is going to transplant it to another mountain and it's going to take root. Are you crazy, Ezekiel? Because Israel was seen as a cedar. How is God going to make things grow, especially out of something as horrible as what this is and of what we're going through? Fast forward about 600 years, shy of 600 years, and what takes place? A shoot from the sprout from the Jesse, from the stump of Jesse, comes forth. Things start to happen, don't they? We have Jesus give this parable even about a mustard seed. It's the smallest of seeds. It's the smallest seed that they probably knew at that time. And yet it grows into a large bush. I think the one that I seen when I was over in the Holy Land was about 12 feet high. Could birds take rest in its branches? Sure. But he's not meaning regular birds. He's meaning people from all around the world, from different countries, from different nationalities. They can take and rest in its branches, find shade in those branches. As we read into these stories, all of a sudden they start to make a little more sense. But it's up to us to see those small ways in which God works, isn't it? Because God is always working in small ways. Most often, we don't even recognize it. Especially as God created the world and everything that is in it. And he holds everything in being, including each and every one of us. And he offers us each and every breath we take with our lives. Every heartbeat of our heart, we can give thanks to God for it. But there are many other ways in which we can give thanks to God. Little children. It was an interesting week this past week because on Thursday we had the young adults night and everybody was invited. There were about 12 or 14 people that showed up. I didn't actually count. But one of the things that I noticed, actually it was two things that I noticed, two different things this week. One of the things that I noticed is the little child that was there. He was just learning his voice. And everybody was noticing how sweet it was.
But how often will we notice through a child's life, where does that child get those things? Where does he even come up with them things? We often hear it, don't we? Yet everybody was entertained by this little child that was there. The same thing happened at the funeral. There was a little boy just learning how to walk. Dad was had him right by the collar of the shirt, making sure he didn't fall on the concrete until he got over into the grass. How does a child learn to walk? All of a sudden to get its bearings and the many different things to make sure that they're walking on that path of God. Where do they develop that love of God? You ever notice a little child? It's almost instinctively in them, that love of God. And it's up to us to keep nurturing it, isn't it? Often it gets choked out, probably about the year age 8 or 9 years old. All of a sudden things start to change. Interests of the world start to float in. But how do we take notice of it? And how do we make sure that it continues to grow? Same thing with the church, isn't it? How do we take notice of the small things in the church? Sometimes the things that we don't even notice. One of the things that caught my attention earlier in the week, or actually, I guess it was a couple weeks ago, is that the evangelization team has been putting together the different ministries that are some of the different ministries that are in the parish. I counted them yesterday. There's 44 of them that we know of right offhand. Some of them are school related, some are prayer and study, mass and church ministry, fundraising, partners, mission related, community outreach, administration related, and then faith formation with the youth, young adult, adult-related, family-related, sacramental preparation. How do we take notice of the things that are happening around us? And we grow and see the understanding of how God works in our lives. It's up to us to see it, because he's always there giving us his graces, especially through his word and through his sacraments. I couldn't help but to notice also today, in today's reading, of its own accord, the land yields fruit. First the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. He's talking about wheat. Of course, whole wheat. Whom we receive in the body and blood of Christ. That wafer is made of whole wheat and water. That's it. And it's transformed into the body and blood of Christ. And we feed upon him. And he nourishes us. And we are allowed to grow in his wisdom, his knowledge, and his love. The understanding of who God is and the way in which he works in each and every one of our lives. It's up to us to grasp hold of it, to see the way in which his spirit works in our lives so that it can become a part of everyone else's life. God wishes nothing more than everyone born in this world to come and take shade under his branches, to recognize the love that he has for us. But that's up to us to speak that love to other people, to everyone whom we come in contact with. May God continue to show us his love and enrich us with his understanding and allow his spirit to work in our lives.
Let's rise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and for the world to come. Amen. And with trust in our merciful God, we turn to him with these petitions.
For the Church, may she continue to learn from Jesus Christ, who continues to guide her steps as she brings the message of salvation to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people throughout the world, may they become aware of God opening their hearts to receive his word. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have served and are serving in the armed forces, may they find your heavenly grace in keeping peace in difficult situations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all church members in the Diocese of Superior, may we live out the mission of sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ in their daily lives as a witness of faith in their families, work, and public places. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have wandered from the faith, may they see through our witness God's love guiding them back into his loving arms. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community gathered here, may God help us have eyes to see and ears to hear all who are in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, marked as Christ's own forever, may God welcome them to his eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Lori Krasmarski, who this Mass is intended, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join us in praying the vocations prayer. O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart, and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, and choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let's also pray. I have a couple more prayers. Let's also pray for our fathers on this Father's Day weekend, that that spirit continue to enrich and lighten their hearts, and may the dignity of fatherhood be continued to be uplifted. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And in thanksgiving for all the people who are involved in the many ministries around the church, that that life of Christ may continue to go out, and may they continue to proclaim that life of Christ in the people they meet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, hear the prayers we offer you and answer them according to your gracious will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
As we present our gifts to the Lord, let us sing together number 428, Many and One.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. And we'll be using the fourth Eucharistic prayer this morning. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy. For you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life, and that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us. He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broken, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." in a similar way. Taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant, Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ, keep me safe for eternal life.
This is Jesus. Emmanuel.
Number 623.
We till the earth, we tend the ground, so
thank you.
And please remain seated for the prayer after communion. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. And just a few announcements. First off, just a reminder for everybody, please pray for Extreme Faith Camp. We should have included them in the prayers also. That's June 16th through the 21st. Also, script is available in the back of the church. And lastly, I didn't mention it last night, but I had printed up about 6 copies of it and they were all gone. Forming Consciences for Faithful Citizenship. It's what's been put out by the USCCB on how we form our consciousness and to become faithful citizens, especially in the political life around in the United States. So there's I printed out about 12 more copies, and they're on the table in the back of the church. And lastly, let's have a blessing. If we could have the fathers all please stand. On this Father's Day, let's raise our hands towards our fathers. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of Saint Joseph be their guide, and may their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them and always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And please rise for a blessing. May Almighty God bless you in his kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you. Amen. May he nourish you always with the teaching of the faith and make you persevere in holy deeds.
Amen.
May he turn your steps towards himself and show you the path of charity and peace.
Yes.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Our Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And as we go forth, let us sing together number 433, Canticle of the Sun.